The village of Veselo is located in the rear of the Russian Armed Forces Group. To Glushkovo, where the pontoon crossings of the Russian army are located, 7.5 kilometers by road. So, new units of the Ukrainian army have entered the Kursk region of Russia. Dragon's Teeth, set up by the invaders and artillery fire could not stop the fighters advancing in the direction of Glushkovo settlement with a large number of armored combat vehicles. The advancing Ukrainian fighters managed to enter the territory of the settlement by opening fire on the positions of the Russian army nearby. Recall: the Russian Defense Ministry reported that Russian forces have retaken 10 settlements south and southwest of Koronivo since launching counterattacks on the night of 10 to 11 September. These settlements include Apanasovka, Bayakovo, Vishnevka, Viktorovka, Nezupnoy, Gordivka, Krasnoktyabrskoy, Obakovka, Snagist, and 10th Oktyabr. However, all of these areas fall within previously claimed limits of Russian advances. Ukrainian officials said Moscow has sent some 30,000 troops into the Kursk region. Two officers with knowledge of the situation said these reinforcements included soldiers from the now-dissolved Wagner private military company who the officers believed had been redeployed from West Africa. The Wagner mercenaries were meant to be officially absorbed into the Russian military following the death of Wagner boss Yevgeny Prigozhin last year. But the Ukrainian soldiers operating in Kursk said Wagner fighters were distinguishable from the rest of the Russian troops because they have much better equipment and are better trained than the regular soldiers. Chechen leader Ramzan Kadyrov also claimed shortly after the start of the incursion that the Chechen Special Forces Unit Akhmat was in the area. In the days leading up to this counterattack, CNN spoke with 14 Ukrainian soldiers from 5 different units who were deployed to Kursk as part of the incursion. "Four were wounded in the operation and are currently recovering in hospitals in Ukraine, while the other 10 are still conducting missions in Russia. They included infantrymen, members of a drone unit, armored vehicle drivers and sappers, or frontline combat engineers. Most have asked to remain anonymous or be identified by their first name and call sign only, given the sensitive nature of the topic and security concerns." All 14 said the Kursk counteroffensive was a difficult operation with casualty rates on par with other parts of the front lines. They said it was getting tougher, 5 weeks in, and some even questioned the decision to launch the incursion at a time when Ukraine was struggling to defend key towns and cities in the east of the country.
Очко, мужики, все сгорело, все, что можно, нахуй нельзя. Все машины, одна перевернута. Не знаю, каким она образом перевернулась. Колина, машины ничего не осталось. Шестерка, ничего не осталось, пацаны. Сейчас еще внутрь, патроны вроде все, нахуй, прошли. Попробую зайти. Сюда вот. Никого не осталось. Все, ладненько, давайте.
Три машины. На одной купол. За 400 рублей. Купленные, блядь. Своими деньгами, блядь. Пизда. Просто пизда, ебать. Просто пизда, нахуй. Блять, новый генератор, ебать. Блять, сука. У расчета вещей нет. Все. Нихуя нету, блядь. Три машины, нахуй, по пизде. Пизда, нахуй. Я не знаю. Патроны взрываются. Я текать нахуй.
Да. Короче, мужики, все посмотрел. Вот она, Серега, твоя четырка. Вон она, нахуй. Колина, твоя четырка. Шестерка. Ничего, ребят, не осталось. Вот генератор новый. Все. Вообще все пусто. Никакой хуйни не осталось. От слова совсем. От слова совсем. Ничего, пацаны, не осталось.